to the Uncommon Transformation television series.
Welcome to Akwa Ibom 6, the land of uncommon transformation. Come and join us, live amongst us, and invest, and you will not regret. I welcome you.
The transformation initiative of the Governor Godswill Obodokpabi administration traverses the length and breadth of Akwa Ibom state, even to communities where basic social amenities had been lacking for close to 50 years. Worst affected were communities in Etimekpo Ika local government axis. For the people of these communities, life was so frustrating and difficult that most of them had to perpetually relocate to other places and apparently shunned entreaties to return home. Reason being that for close to half a century, there was no access road in the area. Thus, it was absolutely difficult to move from one place to the other. For instance, a journey of 10 to 15 minutes became a full day's tortuous journey. At a point, bicycles and boats were the only means of transportation as commercial vehicles stopped plying the route or came in trickles. Despite the socio-economic significance of the area as a major gateway and fastest connection to Port Harcourt in Rivers State and Aba in Abia State, the area was neglected by successive administrations, leading to total loss of confidence in government and general apathy among the people regarding government business. Socio-economic life there came to a dead end. Business concerns were forced to close shop. Churches had fewer members as the congregations grew leaner in size each passing week. Enrollment figures in schools dropped as the migration helplessly continued. There was great despair in the land. Conflict, strife, and intra-communal crisis escalated, leading to a general breakdown of law and order in Ika local government. These continued unabated as security operatives could not access the area following absence of access roads there. At a certain stage, the paramount ruler's residence was razed, same for the divisional police office in Ika, while the DPO was killed in the violence that rocked the area. This forced the council chairman to relocate to a safe area to run the council affairs.
In fact, it was a thing I would consider not in my generation. That is, I wasn't expecting to see any good road in my days. But thanks be to the Almighty Creator of all the world, that at a particular point in time, a savior is sent to a particular set of people to redeem them and to liberate them. And that is what is happening to Etimekpo people. Particularly, if you move from Afarabong Junction down to Iwukem, down to Ika. In fact, this time around, even you are coming, I don't think the next 3-4 hours you would have been able to reach this place from Afarabong Junction. It was as bad as that. In fact, it became a policy, even in the ministry, that whenever you are to be punished, you'll be posted to Otumegbu. But that was the home of what the Bible called the Irongbidiowu.
I want to tell you that we were in hell. Not even hell, maybe hell is better. Because maybe God has provided a way where some people from hell can go out and come back. But in Ika, we find it very, very difficult to come in or go out. That was when the whole place became hideout for all sorts of criminals. We were not free. In fact, the only access road that would link us to our state capital, they were planted on the road. We did not pass here. If you want to come from Uyo, we get to Abak. From Abak, we go to Ekparakwa. From Ekparakwa, we go to Oruwonam. From Oruwonam, we get to Okanafon. From Okanafon, we traverse Otumegbu. And then we go to Abia State at Azumini. From Azumini, we go down to Ika at Ikoroku. That is where we will negotiate how to come to Rainyang.
My brother, it was terrible. You didn't go out. You plan before you come to you. You must plan. You must call a bike that will be able to carry you from your village to you. And there's no way you not meet up to 3-4 bikes that will accept to move from your village to even a back. So it was terrible. We feel rejected. We feel we are not part of the parcel of Abia State.
We really suffered at the Otumegbu. The road was so deplorable in such that people like us, we couldn't go. In fact, some of our people at Calabar, some of the professors lecturing at the University of Calabar, and some business people like that, they couldn't go home because of the road. It was deplorable.
Tong farabong to Otumegbu. Usong mani na kisi iliok mbono gwe se to a jit fin bon to jit se kaula. Iko do song ki gwa bet sa kbabio wa se gano lisi ok babio. A sin ke fa romimi en on wana miro kala mi. En on ke be anjeli nam jiri kulun sio sio mba usong ogo ke lisi kudi sang a jiri kuli sang. Mbong ogo ke lisi kudi ngon a jiri kuti kang a jiri ke lisi kude. A jiri kuti kulumen sio sio mba mfini fin posi dia dia ke lisi ba. A jiri ikuli dia mfaniti en on enjoy yo. Okala mami.
Ekpani ko usun iki ba ina gire. Ika ka ile me ban. Meri sa mi mo ki bi ka aba. Ama ri ok etiet. Tutu fori ku son bono be. Sigi si bono. Are u kama ki boyo ati boyo ku san ukut me ke na ukwa. Me shine ke ri baba. In fact, me si bo fun etiet. Tutu ura ga ba ga me ko. Iki me gwi woke mi kare kuru so na sa ka da akpo o ke ba se gidi si from no iki me men wore mbere re woke nu nyam ati te o ke re mi do bu ka ade chong chong nko.
The only access road in the area, the Afarobong Otumegbu Iwukem Ika Road, had become a major political debacle as administration after administration overlooked the plight of the inhabitants, despite the huge natural endowment of the area. Available record shows that the road had constantly been appropriated for in the Eastern Region Administration budget since 1963, yet nothing was done on the road, forcing the inhabitants to seek alternative routes in the neighboring local government areas to evacuate their agricultural products. There was, therefore, absence of government presence in Otumegbu local government area, while the few that were there were in deplorable condition. The situation became a constant source of anger to the people anytime any seeker of political office used the construction of the road as a campaign promise. It had to be so because the people had heard so much promise again and again and were not prepared for any further deceits. But Akpabio's promise was to make the difference. That singular message of hope during his electioneering visit to the area in 2007 lifted itself from the pedestal of a political rhetoric to a state of actualization.
When I was campaigning, I went on campaign to Itumekpo, and the people warned me that I should not mention anything about Itumekpo Road, that they had been deceived. Government by government had deceived them. The military will come and make promises that they will do the road. They never did. Civilian administrations will come. They never did. Their Belly Bridge collapsed as far back as 1968. They were cut off from Akwa Ibom State. They have to travel to Obingwa local government and cross into Aba before they enter Ikore Gbenan in Akwa Ibom to go to any part of the state. And so I went there. And I went through a lot of difficulties. I finished the campaign about 5-6 in the evening. By 1 a.m., I was still trying to find my way out of the area. You enter here, you end up in the river. You enter here, you end up in the swamp. Because I did not want to go through Abia State. So sadly, I finally had to go through Abia State to be able to access Akwa Ibom. And I was determined. I said, no, we cannot expose these people to this level of suffering. At the time, criminals took over Ikaluku government. For over 3 years, between 2001, between 2001 and 2004, criminals took over the whole of that area. I think the situation was brought to an end by 2005. In fact, there was a divisional police officer who was slaughtered in Ika during that crisis, and his body parts were strewn all over the area, and there was no way, no road for reinforcement to go and help the policemen there. They were overpowered, and so everything closed down. Schools closed down. The police station closed down, and the people were left at the mercy of criminals. So when I went to that area, I said, how could the people be so neglected? I don't want to use the word marginalized. Whatever happened, I felt that no, that if I'm elected governor of the state, I will not sign a single contract unless that Itumekpo Road was involved. And people, they have dignitaries from that area. In fact, the current head of the African Church worldwide is from there, prelate Odofia. Then they celebrated icon and journalist Reepu is also from there. They even had a deputy inspector general of police from there. They've had very eminent sons, but unfortunately, the area was what you saw. So I decided that I would not do anything in this state in terms of any infrastructure in this state unless that road was on the list. And so that was the first contract that I signed in the state. And we finished 56 kilometers complete with a bridge and invited President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan to commission it. And he saw the joy on the faces of the people. You know, so, and you know, they had a joke in the state. They would say in primary schools, they were teaching children as bright as the star. And then they say, as white as snow, as bad as Itumekpo Ika Road. That was the joke in the state. So even children, children were reciting it in primary schools, as white as snow, as bright as the star, and as bad as, then somebody would add Itumekpo Ika Road. That was the story. So for me, that was the beginning of the uncommon transformation, when that road was commissioned to the glory of God and for use by humanity.
If the road was in such a state of disrepair, then the deplorable condition of the bridge there could better be imagined. In fact, report has it that several people died trying to cross the Bailey Bridge constructed during the colonial era. Not too long ago, a truck belonging to a construction company crashed into the river as the bridge collapsed under its impact while trying to cross it. The driver was barely saved by divers who were around at the time the incident occurred. This and other sad stories emanating from this community made construction of the road imperative for any administration with the spirit of humanity. And now, the people are singing a new song. A song of liberation. Liberation from age-long abandonment and neglect, and now appreciating their creator, that they are alive to see development which had for decades eluded them. It's indeed a sweet song. Why not? Courtesy of the Governor Goswill Obot Akpabi administration, a brand new asphalted road now sprawls across the area. The 56-kilometer Etemekwe-Ukem Road, which is one of the several roads constructed by the Akpabi administration, serves as gateway to the state from the eastern axis, even as the East-West Federal Highway passing through Ikorabasi and Okanafun local governments is yet to be completed. Constructed by Setraku Construction Company, the road is built with the latest technology in view of the undulating topography of the area. With such high quality and design, the road is expected to last very much longer. Its spur to Ika local government brings a breath of fresh air to an area long forgotten.
It is the only road in Akwa Ibom say that you have surface dressing first before you put the asphalt. That's and the wearing course. Okay. Yes. So if you, I think the design was perfect. It was not economical at all. The design was not economical because we don't, His Excellency has said that he does not want to construct roads that will come back in 5 years' time to begin to rehabilitate. So the design was properly done and economy was not looked, was not looked at. We just designed the road that would last for 25 years and above.
Indigenes of the area express their appreciation to Governor Goswill Akpabio for living up to his name.
The first day he came in as for a campaign in 2007, wanting to be governor of a private institution, yes. And he promised that if he was going to be a governor of a private institution, he was going to turn things around for the people of the government, which he did. He's a promise keeper. So we want to thank him for coming to our assistance, coming to our head, making us also feel as if we are part and parcel of Akwa Ibom State. You know, Kalogu government area yesterday, like my brother, you attest to the fact that when they say everybody will run away with today, like Akwa Ibom State, everybody wants to be, it's a destination. There is peace in the area, there is tranquility, and there is development.
We also thank the government, even God's will, because the road is better because before, people know how the road is. So we so much thank God because we are okay now.
They will thank God for Chief Dr. Goswill Akpabio that came to redeem us. Even the bridge, we're using Kenu. The very bridge they built, they said, many years ago. Collapsed. So people died. We lost our brothers. We lost our sisters. The then elders of the temple, the big men in the temple, pleaded with government at that time, and they died. Sometimes I felt bad when I noticed that somebody like JBFR could not witness what we have seen today. God brought us here. We can move. I'm working in a temple program as a chairman. Here I am today. We move like that. Every day I go to work and I come back. Even when they meet me in New York, I will be in my office. I work. When it's up to 15, 20 minutes, I will start moving. Before 20 minutes, I'm in New York. So we thank His Excellency God.
Now, you just need to carry stone, block, place on the throttle of the vehicle and sleep. In less than 30 minutes, you are in Urayang. God bless His Excellency Goswill Akpabio.
This place was a dark area. But now the people of Temekpo are very proud that we have a motorable road, a road that can link us to other local government, other state. So we are very happy. I think there is no single small boy or small child that is not happy about this road because we can flow, we can interact, we can move in terms of going to anywhere we want to go. So things are okay. I want to say more grace to His Able. I wish there is another third time or they will say people that done well should continue. I am ready in person to vote for him to go back again because he has done it well.
To be sincerely, any Nigerian man, if you can perform, let the person continue forever. Let him continue. Rotation, no rotation, I don't bother. when a woman, being a Nigerian man, can do something for the benefit of everybody, let the person continue. But they have performed a lot, then all the people in Akwa Ibom State, even Nigeria as a whole, even the, some of the governors are recommending him. It's a magic governor.
Today, we are so happy that we have got a committed governor, that we have got somebody who can actually care for the people that he governs. Well, Chief Dr. Oborokpa Abio has really come to our aid. To see that Etimekpo Road was constructed, and something Etimekpo people have not dreamed of, but today, that is the road so many people are now using to connect other states.
I am so impressed with what he's doing now. And there was some years back when I came home, I drove and passed my compound because of the good road network. He has done well in terms of road, electricity, schools, innovation, especially free and compulsory education. I am so proud of him. That is why we are also bringing in some packages from other states to assist the free and compulsory education issue, you know, thrive.
Traditional rulers, chiefs, and other indigenes of the area bear their minds.
But I am very thankful to the creator of all the world who sends a savior, a redeemer, in the physical person of Chief Dr. Godswill Oborokpa Abio, the governor of Akwa Ibom State, who saw our plight and quietly walked towards it. Before, it was a political gimmick that whenever you come to Etimekpo, just promise them you'll do their route. And you wait 8 years, 12 years, passing nothing, not even a spade, not even a trade wheelbarrow is used to just heap sand and then put on in any gutter. We keep on bearing that, hoping that one day will come to pass. And true, by the special grace of the Almighty, it has come to pass that Etimekpo can now be liberated. That people from Etimekpo can now drive all the way from Uyo to wherever they live within a twinkle of an hour. I say thank be to God. Thank be to the present government of our Chief Dr. Oborokpa Abio.
Idam mpon ko gwo ko si pa je men si abai ti te to ngo ka nye to bu mo de on furu so ama e de pada ka me fo gwa ni ke men ka gwo yo mpere ine me si reti ti he gwa e ka ene ke ti e ka ta ine me si de ka e pon o ku re gbo ku re bi e ti e ke ine me si de na o ka ra agos ro pa de.
Motorists plying the routes and other non-indigents of the area express their feelings about the road.
They have tried so much. Yes. That I appreciate them.
Okay.
What they did for the road, I so like it. That road users are now happy.
Okay.
What the government has done there.
Okay.
So we thank the government.
To come and
there is no any manageable because when you are from here now to Uyo, we take you up to one full day by that time. But as of today, it is not up to 20 minutes. You get to Uyo. Glory be to God, because the man is a very good man. He understands. He's a very, God will bless him more than the one he blessed him before. Because poor people are enjoying this something. Before the time, others are going with bicycle, but now you see them buying motorcycle, buying cars. It is the good management.
Oh, we forgot to tell you that ever since the road was constructed, socio-economic life of the area has picked up significantly. The area, which a short while ago witnessed massive migration of people, is turning into the fastest growing rural area in the state because of its newly adorned cosmopolitan status, courtesy of the benevolence extended to the area by the Akpabio administration through the construction of the road there.
We are doing business very fine, and we are very happy to see this road, because some years ago we haven't seen this road. But by God's grace, God gave